Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Structural Funda. Myself Ethan Kenny, and today we are going to learn about butt joint. Now let us take one example. Now we have given the design data as we have to use M24.6 grade bolt which we use in the lip joint, as well as the size of the plate as 180 by 10 mm. We have given that we have to use double cover butt joint. It means that to connect the butt joint, we have to use two cover plates at top and bottom having 4 mm thick each. It means that we have 8 mm thick plate. Now focusing on design load, which is given as 300 kilonewton. Now let us solve the equation. Now first of all, we have given the bolt M24.6 grade bolt, the value VDSB, which is equal to 45.3 kilonewton, and it is for NN equal to 1. Now we know that for butt joint, we have to take NN equal to 2. It means that if we focus on the equation of VDSB, which is equal to Fu by root 3 gamma MB into NN ANB plus NS ASB, where we take NS equal to 0, and we focus on the equation, we directly says that VDSB is directly proportional to NN. It means that for NN equal to 1, if VDSB is 45.3, then for NN equal to 2, VDSB is 2 times 45.3. It means that our value is 90.6 kilonewton. So we can say that for the butt joint, our VDSB equation, it means that the shear capacity for the bolt is 90.6 kilonewton. Now next part, bearing capacity, and from example number 1, again VDPB we got as 83.64 kilonewton. So at that equation we have taken small t as 10 mm, but in our case our thickness is 10 mm while the cover plate is 4 mm on top and bottom. It means that the summation of cover plate is 8 mm while the total thickness of the plate is 10 mm. We will have the T value as 8 mm. If we focus on the equation VDPB, so VDPB is 2.5 KB D T Fu by gamma MB. KB is constant, D is the given diameter, Fu is 410 and gamma MB is 1.25. It means that we can say that VDPB is directly proportional to T. It means that if for 10 mm thick plate our value is 83.64, then for 8 mm plate it is equal to 83.64 into 8 divided by 10. It means that our VDPB equation is equal to, our value is 66.91 kilonewton. Now for the butt joint, we have the VDSB as 90.6 and VDPB is 66.91. It means that our bolt value is minimum of these two. It means 66.91 kilonewton. Now numbers of bolts required is equal to design load divided by bolt value. It means that our design load is 300 kilonewton, so 300 divided by 66.91, it is equal to 4.48. Now we know that we have to provide the bolts in successive order, so we assume that the numbers of bolt is equal to 5 numbers. For M20 bolt, our pitch value is equal to 50 mm. And an edge distance is equal to 40 mm. let us go with the detailing work, and this detailing also not to scale. Now we know that we have to provide 5 numbers of bolt. So I have assumed that 3 bolts in one column and 2 bolts in another column. Now according to the end distance and pitch distance, the pitch distance is equal to 50 mm, end distance is equal to 40 mm. Now another thing, in the gauge value, the distance between 2 bolt is, now we have given the plate size as 180 cross 10 mm. So out of 180 width, total 100 is given between 2 bolts A to C. Hence total remaining width is 80, which is equally distributed in top and bottom. So these are the dimensions of the given detailing. Now another thing is, if we focus on this zigzag pattern, then from A to D it is equal to 25, from D to B is also 25, B to E is 25, and E to C is 25, while the distance between two columns is 50 mm. It means that if we focus for the zigzag pattern, it means that this is for the zigzag pattern and this is for the row bolting, or we can say that chain bolting. Now zigzag pattern pitch value is known as PSI, while gauge value is known as GI. While in this case, this value is known as gauge. And pitch value is known as P. So we have to solve both the terms, as well as row and chain or zigzag pattern. 4 mm thick is cover plate, 10 mm as our thickness of plate, and 4 mm as cover plate, as well as the distance between D to E is 50 mm. Total we have given as 180, it means that 130 is remaining. So equally distributed through top and bottom, it is 65 and 65. So these are the detailing of the cut joint, where the bolt is M20 4.6 grade. For calculation work, we know that the AG is going to be used, where AG is gross area, which is equal to 180 cross 10, which is equal to 1800 mm square. Another part is net area. So AN is equal to, for A, B and C, it is 180 minus 3 times 22 as the diameter of all into 10. It is 1140 mm square. For bolt of A, B and C. Now next AN. For D to E, which is equal to 180 minus 2 times 22 into 10, which is equal to 1360 mm square. Now if we going for the zigzag pattern, we have A, D, E, C. So for A, D, E, C, AN is equal to 180 minus A, D, E, C, it means 4 numbers of bolt, plus 2 times zigzag pattern at A to D and E to C. So it is 2 times PSI square. So 50 square divided by 4 into GI. It is equal to 25 into T. According to the equation, AN is equal to B minus NDH plus sigma PSI square divided by 4 GI into T. 1420 mm square. Now out of these three value, we have minimum as 1140 mm square. It means that we have to take AN is equal to 1140 mm square, while AG equal to 1800 mm square. First check is yielding, and our equation is TDG is equal to AG Fy by gamma m0. Now AG, as we calculated, as 1800 mm square, Fy is 250, gamma m0 is 1.10, equal to 409.09 kilonewton, is very greater than our design load, It means safe in yielding. Now second one is rupture criteria. So check for the rupture. Our equation is TDN is equal to 0.9 AN FU by gamma M1, where AN is equal to 1140 mm square, FU is 410, while gamma M1 is 1.25, which is equal to 336.53 kilonewton, is very greater than our design load. It means that it is also safe. Now our both the criteria is safe for the detailing work. It means that our design is safe. So we can say that for 180 cross 10 mm thick plate, if we provide M24.6 grade bolt as shown in the figure, our design is safe. Now if you have any query regarding to the example, you can mail me. My mail ID is described in the description link. Thank you.